You know, when adapting a figure as infamous as La Llorona, how important is it to depict the culture that created it accurately?
It's extremely important, and I think, you know, Raymond can also talk about this. I mean, this is something we have grown up with, and doesn't matter. I'm from Venezuela, I grew up in Mexico. It doesn't matter what country this is. It's not just a legend. It's not just a ghost. It's not a story. It's not a folktale. She's real. La Llorona is real, and she doesn't stop when you cross the border. She goes with you everywhere. That was the first thing Michael said when we met, how important it was to do right by La Llorona.
Wow, she's ingrained in our culture so deeply. I mean, we've learned about it as little children, and our grandparents, our parents learned about it as little children. So she's been around for a very long time. So it's great that she's finally got a movie.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Because, you know, people will talk about it.
Right, and it's important that the depiction is correct, and that people understand the legend that we grew up with and the story, and then the feelings that it engenders as you're watching this, because it's fear. It's an encapsulated fear, you know, and it's not the unknown like the boogeyman. You have no idea. We know her origins. We know who she is and what she's capable of. So it's great. It's great to be a part of the film and to contribute to telling the story.
Linda, I have a making of question. There's a lot of stunts.
Yes.
I think I saw you fly into a wall about 50 times.
Yes.
Can you tell me a little bit about that process and the making of that, you know, doing the stunts and that experience for you?
I had an incredible stunt woman who was very good at that. And then I had a different person who I think went into the water, because there was an even longer version of a fight under the water, but there was a truncated version of the movie. But she was fantastic.
She did it. She was in the water.
Yeah,
but
absolutely.
I did a lot of it. And to me, it was fun. It was something that I didn't expect about doing a film like this. I haven't really done a film like this. The idea of coming home at night and being emotionally exhausted, because you're always screaming, yelling, crying, chasing, running, pounding. And I'd come home and the next morning, oh, my arms are sore, I'd get bruises on my hands, you know, and the scenes where I'm being dragged down the hall or thrown against the wall. Like, I really liked to do as much of that as I possibly could, and then the next morning you pay for it.
But yeah,
you forget, and you do it all over again.
What do you think audiences will be thinking about when they're driving home after seeing this film?
I think they're going to be aware, especially when they're driving, but when they get home and when they turn the light off and they go to bed, you know. Yes, it's definitely going to stay with them. There is a before and after, La Llorona.
And you're hyper aware of sound. I found that after I'd come home from shooting and everybody else would be asleep, and every sound sort of makes you jump. And I think that's because you hear her before she gets you. You hear her crying.
Well, I think audiences will be aware that we contribute something to the horror genre that's uniquely ours, and it's a cultural bridge. And then people will get to, it's like the movie Coco, where people got a sense of Day of the Dead, and this is another gift from the Latin culture to the rest of the people.
Could you talk a little bit about directing child actors in subject matter that is about hurting children?
All of the credit goes to those kids. You know, I think that, you know, I lucked out with my entire cast, and, you know, the kids were just another example of that. They were amazing, and I think that they really, you know, kids, I think, you know, they're so easily scared because they're so close to, they're small, they're vulnerable. You are still scared of the dark. You are still scared of strangers and all these things. So all that fear is like just right under the surface. So you don't need to do that much to kind of dig it out. You can just say a couple things and they're scared. They're totally into it. And that was just one of the most fun things. I think that, you know, especially in horror movies and, you know, the horror movies I grew up on and the scary movies I grew up on, it's always like a kid in danger. There's something so captivating about just, you know, that kind of wide-eyed, you know, kid in terror.
Well, Michael failed to mention that we lost the first set of kids. These were the second.